In today's video, I want to show you guys how to restore a flat top grill. Now, this is my Camshaft 4-burner flat top grill. You guys can see I didn't properly store it over the winter time. I got lazy, and this is what happens. Now it's around May, and it's getting warmer out, and we wanted to grill up some burgers tonight. So we figured, let's go ahead and get this thing restored. I'm gonna show you guys how to restore this thing. Out of all the barbecuing equipment that I have, this is actually my favorite grill to use. And I'll show you guys, I'll probably make some videos of me actually using this thing and show you guys why this grill is so awesome. Or having a flat top grill in general is awesome. But yeah, let's go ahead and get to it. So let me just show you guys how bad this looks right now. It's covered in, it's got grease from the last time I used this thing. And just like crud. That's probably cheese from the last time I used it. And I used this, what, maybe like a good 5 months ago, right before the winter. Just wanna show you guys the equipment that I'll be using for this tutorial. This is my handy dandy Harbor Freight angle grinder. You can find these things for like under $30 or $20 at Harbor Freight. Pretty cheap, get your money's worth out of this. I've had this actually for several years, it's done me well. Get yourself some sanding discs. I bought some sanding discs off of Amazon. I'll go ahead and put a link in the description below for everything. But yeah, the sanding discs, I actually got these off of Amazon, but you could find these at Harbor Freight as well. Personally, I have a 40 grit sanding disc on here, and that's just because that's what I have available to me. Got a flathead screwdriver, and I'll show you guys what that's gonna be used for. I got some scuffing pads. I've seen guys use like the sanding blocks or whatever. But this is what I have available to me, guys, and we decided to grill kind of last minute on a Sunday, and so like all the hardware stores are getting close to being closed, so I figured I'll work with what I have. Over here I have just a spray bottle with some dish soap, diluted dish soap solution in here, so it's just like a couple pumps of dish soap and just the rest of it water. And then I've got a spray bottle or a little squirt bottle with vegetable oil, canola oil, and then just some paper towel. But yeah. Oh yeah, one last thing that you want to get is your safety glasses, because you're going to have a whole bunch of crap flying up. And maybe some gloves, but I'm too lazy to go grab my gloves. All right, so with your angle grinder and your sanding disc, you're just going to go ahead and turn this thing on, and you're just going to get to work. So here, let's do this section just to show you guys. Alright, so I don't know if you guys can see that, but that's just a little spot right there just to show you guys an example. It's nice and smooth, but yeah, it's probably going to rip off this coating, whatever this coating is, but we're going to go ahead and recoat it anyways with our vegetable oil. And there's Dozer. Hey, Doze! Say hi, bud. He's focused on his toy. But yeah, when you are using this angle grinder, you don't want to have it face flat like that. You kind of want to have it kind of at an angle. I'm guessing that's why they call it an angle grinder, I'm not sure. But yeah, you're just gonna kind of go back and forth in the motion. You don't really want to stay in one spot, because then you might sand it a little too deep, and you're gonna end up with like a little divot. So I'm just going back and forth with it. But yeah, that's how to do it, guys. All right, guys, so here we are after using the sanding disc. The sanding disc actually got a whole bunch of debris on me and on the lens of the camera as well. However, this is what it looks like after using the sanding disc, and it's still a little bit greasy just because I had a whole bunch of oil or grease left in this area. But because the sanding disc is circular for these corners, it can't really get to the corner, so I tried to get as close as possible. And then for like right here, I'm just gonna go ahead and use a flathead screwdriver and just kind of pry off all that crap. And then I did go ahead and grab some, my scuffing pads. I think they're just called scuff pads, I'm not sure what these are, But you could probably use some kind of abrasive pad or something that you could find at your local hardware store like Home Depot or Lowe's. But yeah, it's not too abrasive. If you can see, it looks kind of like a like what do you call those, like the dishwashing scuffing pads or whatever. And then so we're gonna go ahead and just give it a nice scuff down, just kind of smoothing things out. It is actually pretty smooth. Just like I said with the sanding disc, keep that movement constant. You don't want to stay stuck or else you'll gouge it too deep. It came out pretty good. We're gonna go ahead and scuff it a little bit, get those corners, and then go ahead and clean it. Probably gonna use just like a dish soap solution. So I'm gonna go ahead and get some water and dish soap in here, diluted dish soap, and then just rinse it down a whole bunch of times and, you know, wipe it down. And then we'll go ahead and do the seasoning portion of it, where we heat it up with the canola oil and stuff. But yeah. All right, guys, so I just got done scuffing it down and I went ahead and got some dish soap solution and sprayed it. I'm just gonna kind of let it soak up the grease and all the crud. And just to kind of rush things, I'm just gonna go ahead and carry this top port over to my hose and I'm just gonna spray it down. However, you can use just like your spray bottle and some paper towels, but I'm just gonna try to rush the process here and go spray it down and come back and show you guys how to season it. So here it is after it's all rinsed off. Go ahead and wipe it down. So just because I had a whole bunch of grease on here from leaving it out after my last cook, I did go ahead and get some like degreaser. Not really degreaser. It's like a multi-purpose cleaner for when you're cleaning your sink inside the house or something like that. I personally used Fantastic. I think that's what it's called. It's all-purpose cleaner. Fantastic. I went ahead and sprayed it down and kind of let it absorb the grease and all that. And then I went ahead and rinsed it off with the hose. I usually use my pressure washer to like rinse this off, but we're kind of in a time crunch, and with the hose it actually came out pretty good. All right, so now what we're gonna do is I'm gonna go ahead and hook up the new propane tank and fire her up. All right, guys, so now the grill is actually getting hot. It's fairly close to reaching its hot point. We're gonna go ahead and grab our canola oil or vegetable oil. And I forgot to mention this, but if you do have a flat top grill, then you probably do have one of these, or just get a spatula. I'm just gonna use this to spread the oil on the grill. What we're going to go ahead and do is just gotta go ahead with the canola oil. Just generously spread it around. And then we're just going to go ahead and spread it. All right. We'll let that get hot on there. And then we'll go ahead and turn off the grill, let it cool down while that's let that oil cake onto it. And we're probably gonna do this maybe like two or three times. And then after that final cool down, we should be ready for use. So we'll go ahead and fire it back up after it's all cooled down, fire it back up, let it heat up, and go ahead and use it like your regular flat top grill, guys. The grill over to my normal grilling station, closer to the door. You can see right here, it's been it's been getting hot, and now the oil is kind of like smoking off. At this point, we're gonna go ahead and turn it off. We'll go ahead and turn off the smoker, flat top grill. We're gonna go ahead and turn off the flat top grill or the heat and let that oil cake onto it as it cools down. And then we'll go ahead and heat it up one more time, dab some oil on there like we did before, and then let that cool off, and then we should be ready for grilling. I wanna bring up one more point. My wife actually brought up a good question. She was asking me why the top isn't black anymore. Originally when I bought this, it was a black top, and that's because I believe this top right here isn't cast iron. Usually these come in cast iron. I believe this is aluminum, but I can't remember, so don't hold me to it. However, that black surface that was on there, that's actually like a coating that they put on there. It's kind of like when you buy a new pan from from wherever, your new cooking pan, and then you go to like scratch it up with your like spatula or something. That's kind of like the same idea. However, in my having, I've had this probably a little over 2 years, and using the spatula and all that over the couple years, it kind of, it scratched up that surface and, exposed bare metal, and that's how it started rusting. But I thought aluminum doesn't rust, but it's more of like a surface rust from being exposed to the elements. However, I'm not like a scientist or anything like that. I don't know much about rust and all that as far as metal. But yeah, this, I'm just letting you guys know that's why it's not black and now it's silver. And you guys can see it's turning yellow. That's actually the oil, caking on there, the vegetable oil. So we'll, like I said, we'll do this a couple times. All right, guys, so I got the second coat of the seasoning or whatever, canola oil, on there. Right now I'm getting it hot to where I can cook. It's actually pretty hot, ready for cooking. I'm gonna go ahead and make some burgers tonight. That'll probably be in a separate video. However, thank you guys for watching. I'll go ahead and put a link to all the equipment that I used today in the description. I'll go ahead and put links to all the equipment that I used today in the description below. Feel free to follow my food page. It's Moyardi's Backyard Barbecue. I'll probably put the page right here. But go ahead and like, share, and subscribe to the channel so you can stay up to date with shenanigans here at Backyard Pit Stop. As always, guys, thank you guys for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.